joining us here at St. Luke Church as our parish celebrates the 15th Sunday in Ordinary Time. We are especially grateful that you are with us in prayer to support one another during these challenging days for our families and our world. We will be praying together in a special way this weekend for all of you, our parishioners, and the Wanat family, Albert Herman, Walter Sutherland, and Paul Schiavone. And now, let us all be one in mind and heart as we come together to give praise and thanksgiving to our Heavenly Father in and through Christ Jesus our Lord.
Father, God, Jesus Christ, one begotten Son, Lord God, Almighty God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
You take away the sins of the world,
receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who show the light of your truth to those who go astray, so that they may return to the right path, give all who for the faith they profess as Christians the grace to reject whatever is contrary to the name of Christ, and to strive after all that does it honor. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
Reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, just as from the heavens the rain and snow come down and do not return there till they have watered the earth, making it fertile and fruitful, giving seed to the one who sows and bread to the one who eats, so shall my word be that goes forth from my mouth. My word shall not return to me void, but shall do my will, achieving the end for which I sent it. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The seed that falls on good ground will yield a fruitful harvest. The seed that falls on good ground will yield a fruitful harvest. You have visited the land and watered it. Greatly have you enriched it. God's watercourses are filled. You have prepared the grain. The seed that falls on good ground will yield a fruitful harvest. Thus have you prepared the land, drenching its furrows, breaking up its clods, softening it with showers, and blessing its yield. The seed that falls on good ground will yield a fruitful harvest. You have crowned the year with your bounty, and your paths overflow with a rich harvest. The untilled meadows overflow with it, and rejoicing clothes the hills.
The seed that falls on good ground will yield a fruitful harvest.
The fields are garmented with flocks, and the valleys blanketed with grain. They shout and sing for joy.
The seed that falls on good ground will yield a fruitful harvest.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, I consider that the sufferings of this present time are as nothing compared with the glory to be revealed for us. For creation awaits with eager expectation the revelation of the children of God. For creation was made subject to futility, not of its own accord, but because of the one who subjected it, in the hope that creation itself would be set free from slavery to corruption and share in the glorious freedom of the children of God. We know that all creation is groaning in labor pains even until now. And not only that, but we ourselves, who have the first fruits of the Spirit, we also groan within ourselves as we wait for adoption, the redemption of our bodies. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Hallelujah. O Lord.
On that day, Jesus went out of the house and sat down by the sea. Such large crowds gathered around him that he got into a boat and sat down, and the whole crowd stood along the shore. And he spoke to them at length in parables, saying, a sower went out to sow, and as he sowed, some seed fell on the path, and birds came and ate it up. Some fell on rocky ground, where it had little soil. It sprang up at once because the soil was not deep. And when the sun rose, it was scorched and it withered for lack of roots. Some seed fell among the thorns, and the thorns grew up and choked it. But some seed fell on rich soil and produced fruit, 100, 60, or 30-fold. Whoever has ears ought to hear. The disciples approached him and said, why do you speak to them in parables? He said to them in reply, because knowledge of the mysteries of the kingdom of heaven have been granted to you, but to them it has not been granted. To anyone who has, more will be given, and he will grow rich. From anyone who has not, even what he has will be taken away. This is why I speak to them in parables, because they look but do not see and hear, but do not listen or understand. Isaiah's prophecy is fulfilled in them, which says, you shall indeed hear but not understand. You shall indeed look but never see. Gross is the heart of this people. They will hardly hear with their ears. They have closed their eyes, lest they see with their eyes, and hear with their ears, and understand with their hearts, and be converted, and I heal them. But blessed are your eyes, because they see, and your ears, because they hear. Amen, I say to you, many prophets and righteous people longed to see what you see, but did not see it, and hear what you hear, but did not hear it. Hear then the parable of the sower. The seed sown on the path is the one who hears the word of the kingdom without understanding it, and the evil one comes and steals it away. What was sown in his heart? The seed sown on rocky ground is the one who hears the word and receives it at once with joy, but he has no root and lasts only for a time. When some tribulation or persecution comes because of the word, he immediately falls away. The seed sown among the thorns is the one who hears the word, but then worldly anxiety and the lure of riches choke the word, and it bears no fruit. But the seed sown on rich soil is the one who hears the word and understands it, who indeed bears fruit and yields 100, 60, or 30-fold. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
How many of you are familiar with curry leaves? So I would like to share a story about curry leaf plant. So they're like, curry leaves are like the bay leaves. You know, they use it for, in American food, we use it for flavor, to add flavor. The same way in Indian food, especially in South Indian food, they use this curry leaves. They look exactly like the bay leaves, but smaller in size. And they use it for flavor in Indian cooking. So one day, last winter, around November, I think, and someone gave me a curry leaf plant. And, you know, I brought it to my room and I was, you know, watering it every day so that it may grow. But after a few days, you know, I forgot to water the plant. And by the time I realized that I needed to water the plant, it started losing color and drying up. I tried my best to revive the plant by watering the plant twice a day and stirring the dirt around it and so on. And irrespective of whatever I did, I could not revive and save the plant. When I reflected on what happened, I first of all realized that I did not have a green thumb like Marcia. And second of all, I realized that I did not care enough for the plant, namely watering it, nurturing it, and tending it regularly. Today, as we listen to the parable of the sower, in the gospel reading, you and I are invited to water, nurture, and tend with the life of God that was poured into us through our baptism, and to open our hearts, minds, and spirits to God's word and to his promptings, so that we may be like the rich soil that bore rich fruit 30-fold, 60-fold, and 100-fold. In the first reading of today, Prophet Isaiah talks about the power of the Word of God. He compares the Word of God to the rain. He says, just like the rain that comes down from heavens and waters the earth, making it fertile and fruitful, so will be the Word that comes from God's mouth. It will not return without achieving its end. So when I was reading it, you know, this thought came to me. Of course, God's word is so powerful, right? You know, he created the whole world by his word. Let there be light, he said, and there was light. So God's word is so powerful. But why then, you know, he is not able to pierce through our hard-heartedness and change and transform our lives? Why? Have you thought about it?
Free will.
Free will. You know, even though God can, you know, change our hearts, you know, God can pierce through our hearts, but, you know, he will not do it. He will not transform our hearts without our cooperation. God will not achieve it without our cooperation of openness to God's word and promptings, our cooperation of participating in the faith celebrations of the faith community, our cooperation of reading his word and reflecting on it, our cooperation of reaching out to people who are in need. That's why St. Augustine said, God, who created you without your cooperation, will not save you without your cooperation. So it is a collaboration between God and us. So the question we need to ask ourselves today need to be, in what ways God is inviting me to cooperate with him and his word so that I may become a fertile soil and bear fruit richly by my life. In the parable of the sower sows the seed liberally, in the sense that just sows them like this, right? Sows them everywhere. In the same way, God sows his word in each and every one of us in abundance. He gives his God self, his love, and every love to Jesus Christ the Son, to each and every one of us without measure. But the million-dollar question again is, how generous are we in opening our hearts to God and receiving God's word and His life in our lives? With what attitude we receive the word of God in our lives? So let's pause for a moment and reflect on it. How generous are we in opening our hearts to God and receiving God's word and His life in our lives? God constantly invites us to love, giving, caring, and sharing. Do we hear this invitation? Think constantly calling us to do that. Love me, give me, care, compassion. Whenever we come to the church, whenever we read and reflect on the word, when we listen to the word of God being proclaimed, these are the things that is God constantly invites us. But do we listen to Him? Do we hear His invitation? Let's pause for a moment and reflect. Are our hearts like the path which comes in the parable of the sower? Are our hearts like the rocky ground? Are our hearts like the thorns with worldly distractions and anxiety of the world? Are our hearts like the rich soil? In a few minutes from now, our Lord Jesus Christ is going to come into our hearts. So let us, when He comes into our hearts, let us ask the Lord for this grace. What is that one thing the Lord is inviting you and me to do in order to make your heart and my heart a fertile land for the word of God? When He comes into our hearts, let us ask the Lord for the grace to reveal this truth to us, so that we may make our hearts as a fertile land and bear rich fruit, 60-fold, 30-fold, and 100-fold in our lives. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let's all stand now and profess our faith solemnly.
I believe in one God, Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible.
I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God,
begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father.
Through all things for me, for us in heaven, for our salvation,
came down from heaven. And by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
My friends, let us bring our prayers and petitions before the God who lavishes us with great love.
that the church throughout the world might be more and more dedicated to sharing the good news of God's compassion and care in these difficult times. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all people in our country, especially those who are suffering the worst of the pandemic outbreak at this time, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Again, for all people in our country that our differences of opinion and belief may lead us to desire dialogue rather than angry debate, caring rather than condemnation, and peace rather than violence, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all in our country who are viewed with unjust suspicion or hatred for any reason, that every follower of Jesus may embrace them as sisters and brothers, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are vacationing or traveling, for their renewal and refreshment, and for their safe return home, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of you, our parishioners, for the Wanat family, Albert Herman, Walter Sutherland, and Paul Schiavone, whom we remember in a special way in our masses this weekend, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died, especially Ruth Monacelli, and those who have lost their lives in the pandemic, and for those who are ill, especially Lou Rachinsky, Dr. Sean Finnerty, Armando Fuscianti, Rosie Menino, and Annie Miele, and all who suffer from the coronavirus, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who serve us in the armed forces, and all who put themselves in harm's way on our behalf, especially first responders and healthcare personnel in the COVID pandemic, and for the needs we now remember in the silence of our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We praise your name forever, O Father, Lord of heaven and earth. Renew us to have hearts of simple and complete trust in you, that we may work together to heal the brokenness of our world. And we ask this through Jesus Christ, your Son, who is Lord forever and ever.
Amen.
Can you receive it? Because of restrictions necessitated by the pandemic, we will receive your offering today as a good yourself collection as we come forward for communion. A basket is available at each communion station for this purpose, and we thank you greatly for your generosity.
Thank you.
sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and for the good of all his holy church.
Look upon the offerings of the church, O Lord, as she makes her prayer to you, and grant that when consumed by those who believe, they may bring ever greater holiness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and every way to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in you we live and move and have our being. And while in this body we not only experience the daily effects of your care, but even now possess the pledge of eternal life. For having received the first fruits of the Spirit, through whom you raised up Jesus from the dead, we hope for an everlasting share in the Paschal mystery. And so with all the angels and archangels, saints and martyrs, we praise you as the joyful celebration we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the Father of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dew fall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and he entered willingly into his passion into bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat up, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, and Frank, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them in the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, his spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you through all the ages, we may merit to go ears to eternal life, and we praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. To whom I invite you, my Lord, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom and the power and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to the apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Peace.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Having consumed these gifts, we pray, O Lord, that by our participation in this mystery, its saving effects upon us may grow through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We have a few announcements. A time-honored tradition in the United States is the cooperative mission collection with guest preachers from all parts of the world. Here in the Diocese of Bridgeport, this outreach takes place on the third Sunday of July. As you may well expect, that visit from a missionary cannot take place this year. Nonetheless, we must continue our participation in the effort to spread the gospel and build up communities of faith as today's gospel has instructed us. There will be two do-it-yourself collections next weekend. Monsignor Andy will be forwarding Bishop Frank's letter to us all during the coming week, along with other important news from the diocese. Please watch your flock notes email for more information. And before the final blessing, we want to thank you all for being here to praise and worship God. Thank you and God bless you. Please join me now in the prayer to Saint Michael.
Saint Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our defense against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly hosts, by the power of God, thrust into hell Satan and the other evil spirits who prowl about the world for the ruin of souls. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
God bless us all, the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.